Hi, my dear friends. How are you all? This is your Sunny and welcome to my Study Smart for Success channel. Friends, today we are going to learn about time and distance. Okay, friends? Friends, I will cover this in two parts. Why? Because friends, you need to understand the concept of the time and distance. Then only you can answer in easy way. And friends, I will show you the formulas and concepts in part 1, and in part 2 I will cover the previous exam questions which are asked in IBPS paper. Okay friends, about times and distance. And friends, before anything, if you are seeing my video first time, please subscribe to my channel and share to your friends so that they will also get benefited. Okay friends, let's start the concept. Friends, as I said, we will cover time and distance part 1. In part 1, we will cover basic introduction, unit conversion and speed and time relations and most used shortcut formulas for time and distance. Okay friends, then I will cover the questions asked in IBPS paper in part 2. Okay friends. Friends, regarding basic introduction. In basic introduction, friends, there is no much introduction for this concept. Because friends, everybody knows from 7th class onwards, 8th class onwards, what is the speed formula. Okay. What is speed formula? Distance upon time. Right, friends? Distance upon friends. Okay. So, I will write here. Distance. Speed, time. Okay friends, see friends, if I am traveling with 40 kilometers, okay, per hour, okay, that means what this means friends, for 1 hour I will travel 40 kilometers, right? Same way friends, in 3 hours how much I will travel, that means in 3 hours how much kilometers I can travel? 3 hours into 40. That means 120 kilometers. See friends, it is simple. That means here 120 kilometers. See friends, I can say like this. Speed into time equal distance. Understand friends, how easy it is? This is basic concept friends. That means friends, why I am saying here like this? In our questions, I will not say again and again distance equal speed into time, speed equal to distance upon by time. Because friends, you need to understand and you need to remember this formula. Then only you can do anything. Okay. In time and distance problems. And friends, I am saying you in yesterday's and day before yesterday's time and IBPS PO exams, time and distance related questions, 14 numbers of time and distance questions have been asked. Okay friends, so please pay attention and get benefited. Okay friends, friends, see what is speed. Speed equal to distance upon by time. Okay, and same way t, time equal to distance upon by speed. Okay friends, and same way distance equal to speed into time. Okay friends, please remember this formula. Okay, first please note it down by pausing my video so that you will come to know later onwards. Okay friends, now friends, I have to tell you a basic concept of unit conversion, and also friends, this is very important, unit conversion, otherwise you will confuse. Okay, okay friends, now say let me say friends, what is 1 kilometer in unit conversion? Friends, I am saying, what is 1 kilometer? 1 kilometer will be the 1000 meters, right? Are you agree na? Very good. And same way friends, what about 1 kilometer? What it means, this is distance. Understands? Okay, same way if I say time, okay, 1 hour, how much seconds friends? 1 hour, 3600 seconds. Are you agree? Okay friends, in questions, normally in bank questions, what are competitive questions, always they will ask either kilometer per hour, okay, KMPH, yeah, kilometer per hour, yeah, meter per second. Okay, friends. And always they ask in kilometer per hour in question, and in answer they will ask meter per second. And same way in meter per second they will ask, and in question they will ask for meter per second, and say meter per second, and ask in kilometers per hour. So that's why, friend, this unit conversion is very important, and I will tell you the simplest. See, friends, there is no rocket science here. See, you can see 2 to 1. How much? 5 by 18. This is the factor of meter per second and kilometer per second. Okay, friends. Now I will say how you can convert, when you have to convert kilometer per hour and meter per second. For say, if you convert, okay, friends, if you want to convert kilometer per hour to meter per second, so, okay, you need to multiply that number into 18, 5 by 18. Same way, if you have to meter per second to convert, okay, 18 by 5. Okay, for example, friends, I will show you example. Otherwise you will get confused. For example, friends, let's say 36 kilometer per hour. What is 36 kilometer per hour? 36 into 5 by 18. How much? 18 ones are 18 twos are, right? 10 meter per second. Understand, friends? How easy it is? Same way, if you having 40 meter per second, then how you can convert it to 40 into 18 by 5? Okay. 144 kilometer per hour. Okay, friends? This is the way how to convert. And friends, I know you will get confused whether I have to, because it is a little bit tricky that 5 by 18 and 18 5. Always remember, friends, if you are having kilometer per hour to meter per second, right? That means when high to low, that means you always need to factor by low. That means whenever denominator, okay, denominator is high, that answer will be the low, right? That means you need to calculate by low value, 5 by 18. Understand, friend? Same way, if you are meter per second to kilometer per hour, okay, you need to always factorize with 18 by 5. Okay, friends? This way you can, that means, friends, high to low, multiply by the lower number, and low to high, multiply with the higher number. That's it, friends, in unit conversion. Understand, friends? Are you agree? Concept clear over, friends? If you are not understand, please tell me. Okay, let's go to the speed and time relation. Okay, friends? See, friends, in speed and time relation, I need to say, like, what is speed and time? Okay, you all know that speed equal to, that is speed, okay, time. Are you right? Okay, friends, what is speed equal to? Here I will say speed equal to distance by time. Same way, time equal to distance by speed, right? That means, friends, what is the ratio, speed, always speed inversely proportional to time. Yeah, time inversely proportional to speed. Are you agree, friends? That means, friends, let me say with the example. If I am going 30 kilometers per hour, okay, 30 kilometers per hour speed way, if I am going 30 kilometers per hour, then what 30 kilometers per hour and reaching in 1 hour, okay, friends, speed and time, okay. If I am traveling 30 kilometers per hour and reaching at 1 kilometer per hour, if I decrease this value, like 15 kilometers per hour, if I am traveling, I am reduced my speed as 15 kilometers per hour, what will be at what time I will reach? Then it will increase the time. That means 2 hours, right? Half speed has been decreased. That's why my time has been increased. That means, friends, if I decrease speed, the time will be increased, right? 2 hours, from 1 hour to 2 hours. Same way, if I increase my speed 60 kilometer per hour, I will reach this 30 minutes, because, friends, I am increasing speed okay, and time will be decreasing. Understood, friends? This concept. Same way, friends, that means if you are, 1 minute, friends. Same way, so that means, friends, how can I say, if I'm having two speeds, friends, this is very important, please understand. And if you are not understand, please comment in my box so that I will get you understand one more time. Okay, friends, and I will explain till you understand. Okay, friends, now see, friends, if I'm having there is a ratio like speed 1 is to speed 2, what I can say 1 is to 2. Okay, friends, and we know S is inversely proportional to T. That means, friends, we can take time 1 is to time 2 equal to 2 1. That's it, friends. This is the ratio you have to always, this is a shortcut, friends, that's why I'm saying. That means S1 is to S2 equal to T2 is to T1. Understand, friends? That means, okay, always inversely, always. That means if you have one more example, if you are having 3 is to 4 speed 1 and speed 2, then your T1 will be the T1 is to T2 will be 4 is to 3. Okay, friends, just reciprocate. Okay, friends, this is the concept, friends. This is the speed time relation, and there are so many questions they will ask in IBPS PO and SBI PO, whatever it is. Always they will ask speed ratio will be the 1 is to 5, and what is the time ratio, and what is the time ratio and what time it will take, 5 is to 1, and time will, they will ask in meter per second to kilometer per hour. So like this way. Okay, friends, now I am going to cover a most important tricks which are in time and distance and how to do this. For this I need to explain some question also, friends, then only you will come to know how to do that. The most usual shortcut formulas for time and distance. Now see, friends, if I can say let me say from point, this is point A, this is point B. Okay, friends, now I say car 1, okay, yeah, whatever, vehicle 1, whatever it is, vehicle 1 at 30, let me say 40 kilometer per hour. Okay, okay, friends, and it is reaching at point B 1 hour late. Okay, same way, if car 2 at same point, it is starting with 50 kilometer per hour. Okay, friends, and reaching it is 30 minutes fast. Okay, friends, and what is the distance between A and B. Okay, friends, these type of questions will come in questions also. And friends, see, if you are doing this question in conventional way, you will take at least 2 to 3 minutes for one question. And also, friends, in this question you have to follow the two factorization method, and then you have to multiply and division, and then 1 is to 2, this all this thing you have to do. But friends, I will show you now a very beautiful shortcut formula so that you will come to understand how easy it is, and you even it in matter of 5 to 10 seconds you can complete this question. Okay, friends, now let me explain my shortcut method. For friends, for example, friends, you can say, okay, in car 1, 40 kilometers hours, it will late by 1 hour, right? 1 hour, right? 1 hour late by. And if you are going with the 50 kilometer hours, you are fast by 30 minutes. 30 minutes means 1 by 2 hour, right? That will be total how much, friends? Total difference, 1 hour plus 30 minutes. That means 1.5 hour. Okay, friends? Now, see, friends, for distance, for distance, for distance there is a formula in shortcut. Okay, one is product of speed into difference in time divided by, okay, difference of speed. Okay friends, that means friends, you can say product of speed, what is product of speed? That is S1, speed 1 into speed 2, right? Okay, into difference time means delta t, right? Divided by difference in speed, that means S1 difference in speed. This is the formula friends, please remember this formula for God's sake. If you want to do time and distance from questions in within seconds. Okay friends, we will place all the values in this picture. What is the speed 1? Speed 1 is 40 kilometers and speed 2 is the 50 kilometers. And what is difference in time? 1 hour and 30 minutes, that means 1 hour, 1.5 hour divided by what is the difference? 10. Right friends, you can 0, 0. Now you can see friends, see 15 4 is 60, that means 6 into 5 30 kilometers is the distance. Understand friends? Oh sorry, 300 kilometers is the fine. Okay friends, 300 kilometer will be the answer. Friends, please remember this formula, S1 into S2 by S1 differentiate S2 into delta t, that means difference of time, formula 1. This is one formula. Okay, now friends, I will show you another formula which you need to be understand and remember this thing. For that I need to explain one more question so that you will come to know the situation of the question. Okay friends, so that you will apply those methods also. And same way friends, from point A to point B, that means, okay, if two cars are starting at the same time, okay, that means with 30 kilometers per hour and this is with 40 kilometers car 2, okay, 40 kilometers per hour, okay, same time they are leaving from point A to point B. And see friends, they will that means car 2 will reach point B faster than the car 1. Okay friends, we can say that at some point they will meet each other. Okay, that is point C. And see friends, in exams they will ask at what distance they will meet each other. Okay friends, at what distance they will meet each other, this is the question they will ask friends. That means friends, AC distance how much they will ask. Now see friends, if you need to do conventional method, it will take again more time, but I will show you the formula and explain you the formula so that you will understand very easily. And always friends, for this you need to have a ratio. Okay friends, ratio of speed. See friends, always take lower speed first. Okay, lower speed first in ratio. Okay, you need a ratio here. Okay friends, that means car 1 is the lower, that means 30 is to 40, 0, 0, that means 3 is to 4 is the ratio. And assume 3 is A, 4 is B, that means car 1 is, car 2 is B. Okay friends, now the formula will be just for AC distance, just double the AB, this means distance, okay, into A by A plus B. Okay, friends? This is the formula. For this purpose, you can say, friends, sorry, friends, here I need to tell AB the distance is for somewhat 140 kilometers. Okay, friends? Here, 140 kilometers. Okay, friends? Now, see, friends, what is the AB 140? You need to double this. That means 2 into what is A? In the equation, we say A is 3. Okay? 3 by what is A plus B? 3 is to 4. That means AB is equal to 7. Just friends, 720 is a. What is the difference? 120 kilometers. That means they both meet each other. Okay. Each other at 120 kilometers. Okay, friends. Now, friends, for your better understanding, I will explain one more question so that you will come to know very easily. Okay, friends. Now say, from point A to point B. Okay, friends. Point A to point B, I will say 90 kilometers. Okay, friends. Now, I can say bus 1, okay, is how much we can say? 50 kilometers, right? Okay, friends, per hour. And bus 2 is 40 kilometers per hour. Okay, friends, what is the, at what time, at what place, that means, at what distance they will meet each other if they start at same time. Okay, friends. Now, see, friends. Now, you first need to get the speed 1 is to speed 2. What is the lower? Lower means 40. Okay. That means 40 kilometers here you need to take and 50 kilometers here you need to take. Okay, friends. And you can say how much? 4 is to 5. See, friends, in previous question, I have taken 30 is the first speed 1 and 40 is the speed 2. And now I have taken taken here bus 2. That means speed 2 I have taken as a speed 1 and speed 1 as a bus 2 has taken as a speed 2. Because, friend, always take lower number is the speed 1. Okay, friends, whatever is the car, either is bus 1 or bus 2, a vehicle 1 or vehicle 2, but always take lower value of the speed as a speed 1. Okay, friends, because you need to take as this speed 1 and speed 2 as, okay, this is A and this is B. Okay, friends, now you understand. I think now you understand. Now, what is the AC distance? Double AB into A by A plus B. Friends, this question you will not get anywhere. Okay, friends, this formula you will not get anywhere. This is my whole concept. So, please, friends, try to understand and also follow the method. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel and share to your friends so that they will also get benefited. Okay, friends. Now, coming back to the question, double AB means, friends, 2 into 90 kilometers into what is A here? 4 divided by 4 plus 5. That means 9. Now, we can say, friends, 2 into 90 into 4 by 9. 9 tens. That means how much, friends? 80 kilometers. That means at 80 AC is 80 kilometers. At 80 kilometers, they will meet each other. Okay, friends. I hope, friends, you understand very well. And friends, in part 2, I will cover the questions which are asked in IBPS PO tomorrow. Okay, friends. Till then, have a nice day. Bye-bye.